Yeah, assalamualaikum and good evening. I think we should start now. Okay, so today will be our last lecture for BCM 523. Okay, so today we are going to focus on the topic of understanding financial ratios. Okay, so we are going to learn some calculation in analyzing the financial strength of the companies. Okay, in order to perhaps to obtain new loan or to expand their business. Okay, so they need financial loans lah. So kita akan tengok macam ni, kita nak check dia punya strength and weaknesses of their financial capabilities. Okay, before we start, okay, let's have a little bit recap on what we have learned last week. Okay, so basically last week I not be able to give you a virtual lecture, okay, like today, because I'm not feeling well last week. So even though the lecture cannot be done virtually, I already give you a recorded version of that particular topic, even though the recorded version is being produced for master student few weeks ago, but more or less the topic is quite the same lah. Okay, so last week generally we have a look on the sources of finance, okay, which can be divided into three: short term, medium term, and also long term. Okay, sources of finance. Okay, the difference is the durations lah. Okay, short term is more on less than a year. Okay, medium term is between 1 to 5 years, and long term is more than 5 years lah. But in a practical way, in real world, perhaps they more focus on short term and also long term loan lah. Okay, so basically because medium term ni is in the middle, okay, there is some sort like conflict identity lah. Okay, perhaps some people will call it as a short term loan and some people will call it as a long term loan. Okay, so that's why I more emphasize on short term and so long term loan. Okay, there are a variety of types of short term and also long term lah. Okay, you can have a look on the notes. Okay, and there are advantages and disadvantages on the types of loan that you want to apply for your business or for your organization. Okay, sure. Can you see my slide? So again, as I mentioned earlier, today is our last lecture, okay, on the topic of understanding financial ratio. Okay. So this is the outline for today's lecture. Okay, we will have some introduction whereby I'm going to have a little bit recap on what I've been explained last week on the recorded video, okay, on the scope of financial analysis and factors that we need to consider in selecting the suitable source of finance for business, and three important questions asked by managers and also investors. Okay, why we need to focus on this question? Because this question are very important, especially when you as a company, you want to apply additional loan for your business, and you want to convince investors to invest in your business, okay, you need to answer this important question. So we are going to have a look what are the questions and how we're going to respond to the questions. Okay. So next, we are going to have a look on the principles of financial statement, okay, which consists of three: balance sheet, profit and loss account, and also the cash flow statement. Okay, I'm going to briefly explain to you what each principle is all about lah. Okay, what need to be included under balance sheet, profit and loss account, and also cash flow statement. And the last part of today's lecture, we are going to have a look on the financial ratios that we need to have to consider in making the business decision. Okay, especially as a bank managers, they are going to have a look on these four financial ratios before they make a decision whether they want to approve your application of loan or not. Or as investors, they're going to investigate your financial capabilities based on these four financial ratios before they decided whether they want to invest in your organization or not. Okay, the ratios are liquidity, asset management, debt management ratios, and also profitability ratios. Okay, so we are going to have a look on each ratios for this. Okay, as an introduction, let's have a look again on the scope of financial analysis, okay, which involve three components. Okay, financial management, management accounting, and also financial accounting. Okay, I already explained last week lah. In terms of financial management, the main responsibility of this first categories is to raise funding. Okay, so kat sinilah akan datangnya in terms of sources of finance. Okay, which sources of finance they want to adapt or employ in their organization. Okay, whether they want to do short term, medium term or long term. And financial management also need to give emphasis on the liquidity level. Okay, why is liquidity? Liquidity is an asset that we can convert into cash in less than a year. Okay, itu yang dimasukkan dengan liquidity. Maksudnya aset yang kita boleh jual, aset yang kita ada, kita boleh convert the asset into cash dalam masa yang singkat. Okay, if possible less than a year. Okay, we need to have a significant level of liquidity in our organization because it's very useful if you face a difficult time, especially during recession ke, macam sekarang pandemic, you cannot run business and so on, so you kena cairkan asset you, liquid. That's why we use the terms liquid. We cairkan asset to convert into cash so we can sustain the business. Okay, so kita kena ada element of liquidity in the business lah. Okay, so that we can convert it into cash. So after we have decided which source of finance we want to apply in our organization, then the management accounting will control the firm activities based on the source of finance tadi. Okay, short term dia akan tengok nak guna untuk apa. Okay, sepatutnya short term untuk short term, long term untuk long term dan sebagainya. Okay, so they're going to control the activities. And the last one is financial accounting. Okay, whereby here we are going to record and report everything. Money in, money out must be properly recorded and reported so that at the end of the day, we know where money goes and from where the money comes in. Okay, kita tahu mana datang duit tu, kat mana duit tu kita belanjakan dan sebagainya. So we need to have a proper record and report so that we can convince the investors, we can convince the bank managers that we have properly recorded our financial accounting. And also in the case of for auditing purposes, okay. So in the future, perhaps ada companies yang apply total quality management, ISO dan sebagainya. Perhaps they are going to be audited. So in order to be audited, they must have a proper record and report of their financial statement. Okay. So basically, the better the manager understand about accounting, the better he can manage their financial well-being, and thus the better their financial decision will be lah. Okay, so if we have as a manager of the company, if you have a good level of knowledge on the financial capacities, you can make the right decision for your company's sustain and also enhancement. Okay, so all businesses must prepare financial status. Okay, so ini rule of thumb dalam business lah. Kita kena ada financial status. Okay, for example, like big companies, they usually will produce what we call it their annual report, which contain basic financial statement in the form of cash flow statement, profit and loss account, and also balance sheet. Ini benda basic tiga yang kena ada dalam business, any business. Even sepatutnya kalau you meniaga pas pisang goreng di jalan pun sepatutnya you kena ada at least profit and loss punya account. Okay, duit keluar masuk dan sebagainya. Alright, so of course big company pun kena ada. And don't be surprised, even big companies pun they don't have their proper financial statements. Okay, so jangan surprise. Sebenarnya ada juga, masih there is still big companies who didn't have a proper financial statement. Okay, so it's a things that the companies, any company should take a look lah, because it's very important for a business. Okay, because without financial statement, it's very difficult for you to focus your business punya plan and so on. Okay, this one also I have a touch last week on the recorded video. Okay, I have touched these factors that you need to consider in choosing the right suitable sources of finance for your business. In our case, for your construction companies lah. Okay, so apa, there are a few factors that we need to consider. The first one, a business should match the source of finance to its specific use. Okay, so means that long-term source of finance should be financed for long-term uses or needs, and short-term finance for immediate needs. Again, as I mentioned earlier, short-term finance should be used for short-term needs. Long-term finance should be used for long-term needs. Yang tu you kena clarify first. Okay, so you kena tengok objective of obtaining a new finance for your business. Untuk apa? Okay, adakah untuk capai matlamat jangka masa pendek, ataupun adakah untuk mencapai matlamat jangka masa panjang? Okay, kalau jangka masa pendek, you need to have a look on the option available for short-term loan. Okay, if for long-term punya plan, so you need to have a look on the long-term punya loans that are available. Okay, itu dia punya rule of thumb yang pertama. You kena tengok the factors that first you need to consider. Alright, the next one is cost of the source. Okay, the cost of the source. Okay, so source of finance yang you nak apply. Let's say, for example, like short-term loan. Okay, so dia punya cost tu. Berapa dia punya interest dan sebagainya. So of course, benda tu you kena consider. Okay, organization objective. Okay, so you kena tengok balik pada company's punya objective. How ambitious your company is. Maybe your company is really ambitious. Maybe your company is targeting to become a global company in a 10 years time, katakan. So in order to achieve that objective, you need a lot of finance. Okay, supaya you boleh capai objective. Okay, tapi kalau your company is not that ambitious, perhaps you don't need a lot of source of finance for your companies lah. Alright, next, in terms of flexibility and availability of the finance. Okay, the flexibility and availability of the finance. Okay, in terms of flexibility, okay, there is some loans that have a maturity period. Dia ada tempoh matang. Okay, contoh you apply for long-term loan. Okay, 20 tahun punya loan tenant, tempoh pinjaman 20 tahun. Okay, tapi selepas 5 tahun, your business doing well. Okay, you find out that the loan yang you ada, yang you ambil long term loan tu is jadi burden kepada you. Okay, sebab you rasa you boleh bayar dah, boleh settlekan. So boleh tak you negotiate dengan bank? Okay, so because dari certain loan yang kena tunggu 5 tahun baru you boleh negotiate dengan bank. Okay, ada certain loan yang flexible anytime. Okay, hari ni you pinjam, esok you nak negotiate balik pun boleh, tak ada masalah. Okay, so you kena tengok in terms of flexibility of the loan. Okay. Alright, next you have to consider the factors is about the impact of the new funding would have on the organization current financial structure. Okay, for example, like its balance sheet. Okay, apa kesan dia kepada balance sheet tu? Okay, adakah dia akan lebih mendatangkan keuntungan pada you untuk jangka masa panjang? Adakah dia akan membebankan you sekiranya you ambil the new source of finance in your business. Okay, so you kena tengok apa kesan dia. Okay, alright, the state of the environment, external environment. For example, the economy and the consumer trends. Okay, so ini faktor ni pun penting juga. Okay, faktor ekonomi, faktor consumer trends. Di mana? Okay, so perlu ke you ambil new loan? Okay, kalau dalam ekonomi yang sekarang agak slow, okay, perhaps ada company yang perlu. Sebab apa? Kalau dia tak ada new loan, dia tak boleh nak survive. Ada company yang tak perlu sebab apa? Dia dah ada strong backup. Okay, so that dia tak perlu new loan dan sebagainya. New sources of finance dan sebagainya. So in terms of demand and supply juga, so maybe there are a lot of demands for your product, there are a lot of demands for your businesses. So perhaps you need a new source of finance in order to expand your product in order to fulfill the demand. Okay, so that in that case, you perlukan new source of finance. So faktor-faktor tu you kena consider. Okay, and of course the last one is the type of business lah. Okay, so ini berbalik kepada organisation objektif tadi lah. Okay, ada company yang very big companies, of course they are very ambitious. Okay, ada yang company sini yang berhad, ada yang company maybe enterprise saja, ada yang company dah group. Okay, macam Sunway Group is a very large company, so perhaps in that case they need a lot of source of finance in order to expand their business and in order to run their business. Okay, next we have a look on the three important questions asked by managers or investors. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, you as a company, you need new sources of finance for your business. Okay, in order to save your business, or perhaps in order to run your business, to expand your business. Okay, so in order to convince the bank managers, okay, you need to answer this question. Okay, in order to convince the investors, also you need to answer this question. What are the questions? First one, what is the company's financial position at the end of the fiscal period? Okay, fiscal period ni biasanya tempoh orang kita tutup account. Okay, normally dalam 6 bulan ataupun setahun. Okay, so kebiasaannya setahun lah. Okay, ada negara yang ambil setahun dia tu bukan Januari to December. Ada yang pakai Jun to Jun. Jun 2021 sampai Jun 2022. Okay, ada negara macam Malaysia, kebanyakan company dia punya fiscal period is January to December. Okay, that's why kita punya year end sale is on December. Okay, so macam mana kita nak jawab soalan ni? Is by providing them with balance sheet. Dalam balance sheet ni lah kita boleh tengok, tunjukkan kepada managers and also investors our financial position. Dalam balance sheet ni akan ada kita punya asset. And akan ada kita punya debt, hutang. Ini two main component yang ada dalam balance sheet. Okay, nanti saya akan elaborate more on this. Okay, but by providing them with this balance sheet, kita boleh menjawab soalan pertama. Okay, the next question, how much profit did the company make during the fiscal period? Okay, profit or loss lah. Okay, ada profit ke tak? Rugi ke tak? Okay, how we going to answer that? By providing that with income statement or profit and loss account. Okay, by providing them with profit and loss account, we can show to the managers and also to the investors how much profit that we make during the fiscal period, or how much loss that we make, kalau rugilah. Okay, and the last question, how much cash did the company generate and spend during the period? Okay, again, fiscal period ni setahun setahun. Okay, how we going to answer that? We can provide them with the cash flow statement. So kat sini, dalam masa setahun kita boleh tunjukkan berapa banyak cash yang kita generate, dekat mana kita spend cash tu. Okay, bayar hutang ke, beli aset ke dan sebagainya. Alright, so that's how you answer these three important questions. Okay, that's why I said, dalam bisnes tiga ni penting, because this is the principles of financial statement, basic yang kita kena ada dalam bisnes: balance sheet, profit and loss account, and also cash flow statement. Tiga benda ni kena ada. Okay, alright, kita tengok a little bit more detail about each of the principle of the financial statement. The first one is balance sheet. Okay, is the balance sheet will report the company financial position at the end of the fiscal period. And there are three components under the balance sheet, which are asset, liabilities, which is the debt, and also shareholders equity. Okay, pemegang saham, pelabur punya duit dalam tu, dia akan tunjukkan. Ini contoh balance sheet. Okay, ni simple one lah, contoh balance sheet. Okay, dia ada asset, dia ada liabilities, and dia kat sini liabilities, and dia ada stockholders ataupun shareholders, sama lah. Okay, ada tiga komponen dalam balance sheet ni. Kita kena tunjukkan aset kita berapa banyak. Current asset, non-current asset. Current asset ni aset jangka masa pendek, non-current asset ni aset jangka masa panjang. Liability pun sama. Okay, ada debt, short termnya liabilities or current liabilities, and kita ada non-current liabilities ataupun hutang jangka masa panjang, long termnya liabilities. Okay, depends lah. kita akan letakkan dalam ni. Ownership as stockholders or shareholders punya equity, kita akan tunjukkan juga dalam balance sheet. Okay, that's what we call it as a balance sheet. Okay, in terms of asset, again as I mentioned earlier, it's divided into two, current asset dengan long term fixed asset or non-current asset. Ini antara term-term yang digunakan lah. Okay, kadang-kadang dia tulis directly long term asset dalam balance sheet ataupun non-current asset. Okay, ini sama lah non-current asset. Okay, same thing. Okay, kadang-kadang dia guna term ni, kadang-kadang dia guna terms long term or fixed asset. Okay, so antara current asset yang ada is cash equivalents, cash in hand, short term investment, account receivable, which is debtors, okay, duit orang yang hutang dengan kita. Okay, maybe kita punya cara business, kita kita bagi barang dulu ke orang, payment dia akan kita dapat kemudian. Okay, that's all part of our asset also. Okay, kita kena tunjukkan juga. Okay, berapa banyak orang berhutang dengan kita. Inventories. Inventories ni benda-benda yang dalam macam contoh if you involved in retailing punya business. Okay, macam dekat Speedmart ke apa dan sebagainya. Barang-barang dalam store yang belum kita display lagi untuk dijual. Okay, itu is part of inventories. Okay, dalam in the context of construction project, work in progress is part of inventories. Kita punya material yang dalam storage lagi yang kita belum gunakan. Okay, that's part of our inventories. Okay, while prepayments is something that is a debt that you paid before the official due date. Okay, you bayar sebelum tarikh sepatutnya. Okay, it's part of your asset also. Macam rent, kalau you ada refinance dan sebagainya. Okay, and while non-current asset, fixed asset ni lebih pada take time. Okay, dia lama sikit. Okay, compare to current asset ni walaupun dia cepat sebab dia dalam bentuk cash. Kebanyakan ni dalam bentuk cash, yang nak convert into cash pun masa dia lebih cepat compare to non-current asset. Okay, it takes time to convert into cash. Macam contoh aset-aset kita yang berbentuk plant and machinery. Okay, kita ada beli, maybe ada beli backhoe ke, okay, kita ada excavator ke in our companies and so on. So, biasanya if kita ada plant and machinery ni dalam business, it's important for us to include also what we call it as a written down value dalam kita punya balance sheet. Apa yang dimaksudkan written down value ni is the depreciation cost. Okay, which is the difference between the original cost of the equipment or asset and all the depreciation accumulated to date. Okay, maksudnya kita kena tunjukkan berapa cost kita beli. Contoh excavator tadi, kita beli RM100,000 katakan. Tapi sekarang harga dia dah susut nilai sebanyak RM80,000. So kita kena masukkan juga dalam balance sheet if possible. Okay, tak masukkan pun tak apa, it's not necessary. Okay, kita ada aset dalam bentuk land ke land or building ke office equipment, motor vehicle, features and fittings. Okay, ni semua more on the long term assets lah. Okay, and of course selain asset, most of the company have their liabilities. Okay, ada hutang dia. Okay, the money that the company owes. Okay, hutang, debt. Okay, so apa bentuk debt ni, sama juga dia ada dalam bentuk current and dia ada dalam bentuk long term liabilities dalam jangka masa panjang. Okay, so hutang yang dibayar dalam masa less than a year. Okay, accrued expenses, ini semua gaji-gaji. Okay, gaji, taxes, interest ke, okay, ada pinjaman dengan bank ke. And then long term liability ni jangka masa panjang. Okay, ada juga overdraft yang more than a year, dividends, accruals. Accruals ni similar apa ni, lebih kurang macam accrued expenses tadi. Okay, tapi dalam bentuk jangka masa panjang lah. Okay, kita ada bonds, kita ada mortgages. Okay, kita beli equipment ke, plan ke, beli tanah ke, yang dibayar dalam masa jangka panjang. Okay, these two element, okay, asset and liabilities are very important. Okay, why it is important? Because kita nak gunakan current asset dengan current liabilities untuk dapatkan working capital. Okay, current asset, current liabilities. Benda ni kena ada dalam balance sheet kita supaya kita boleh calculate kita punya working capital. What is working capital? Adalah modal pusingan kita. Okay, kita nak generate sale. Okay, duit yang kita nak pusing balik. Okay, kita nak generate sale, nak produce product katakan. Okay, contoh macam construction project, kita nak beli machinery, kita nak beli material, kita nak bayar suppliers. Okay, benda yang kita nak gunakan. Okay, rolling. Okay, nak bayar gaji dan sebagainya. Okay, macam mana nak dapat working capital ni adalah perbezaan antara current asset dengan current liabilities. Okay, maksudnya current asset, kita tolak current liabilities, kita akan dapat working capital. So in this case, kita kena make sure current asset kita lebih banyak daripada current liabilities. Okay, kalau liability kita current liability banyak, current asset sikit, maksudnya kita ada problem dalam nak rolling duit. Okay, ini yang terjadi especially on small scale contractors lah. Okay, biasanya small scale contractor, medium scale contractors ni dia ada masalah dari segi working capital. Okay, dia lebih berharap kepada duit, claim money, progress work dia orang untuk dapatkan duit tu untuk rolling. Okay, kadang-kadang ambil masa lama dan sebagainya. Okay, so that's how we determine working capital. Okay, current asset tolak current liabilities. Okay, the last component under balance sheet is shareholders equity. Okay, ini kita tunjukkan ke company's shareholders berapa banyak. Okay, retained earning. Okay, remember last week saya explain pasal retained earning. Okay, ini duit yang kita gain from our business, profit kita sebersih-bersihnya. Okay, yang kita boleh letak balik dalam business. Okay, so kita boleh jadikan dia sebagai equity. Alright. Alright, the next financial statement is profit and loss account. Okay, the name itself is already obvious. Kita nak tengok tunjuk profit atau loss yang ada dalam business kita. Adakah kita buat duit atau kita hilang duit sepanjang setahun yang kita run kita ni business. Okay, so dalam ni apa yang ada, kita punya sales, okay, and then kita punya perbelanjaan, okay, kita apa kita beli, apa kita belanjakan, bayar administration cost ke, electricity ke dan sebagainya sebelum kita generate net profit, untung bersih sebersih-bersih. Okay, so of course ada some tu kita letak gross profit di sini. Ini untung kasar. Okay, sebelum kita bayar tax, sebelum kita bayar hutang-hutang kita dan sebagainya, barulah kita dapat net profit, untung bersih, untung kasar. Ini dua komponen yang kena ada dalam main komponen yang kena ada dalam profit and loss account. Apa yang penting sekarang kita nak tengok adalah net profit before tax, which is our gross profit lah most likely. Okay, sebab untung kasar ni kena tinggi. Sebab apa, kalau untung kasar kita tak tinggi, lepas kita tolak hutang dan sebagainya, takut kita tak ada net profit. Takut jadi negatif. Okay, so kita kena make sure we have a high level of net profit before tax. Ataupun dalam kata lain, kita punya gross profit lah. Okay, and kita kena tunjuk juga earning per share. Yang ni, I'm not to elaborate more lah. Yang ni I need it for master level lah. Kalau you dah sambung master, nanti you akan belajar ni. Earning per share. Alright, the last financial statement is a cash flow statement, okay, which consists of three financial information: operating activities, investment activities and also financing activities. Okay, so operating activities dia tunjuk income from operation. Okay, dia tunjukkan cash yang kita dapat. So daripada situ dia akan tunjuk cash yang kita spend kat mana. Adakah kita beli new asset ataupun kita settlekan hutang. Okay, and then kita tunjuk juga financing activities. Adakah kita gunakan cash tu untuk buat new activities ke, atau financial activities, for example like bayar dividend ataupun kita beli stock, okay, beli saham if company kita ada saham ke dan sebagainya, that kind of thing. Okay, so this is the example of cash flow statement. Okay, ada tiga komponen, okay, operating and investing and also financing activities. Okay, so ini dia punya explanation, operating activities, kita tunjuk profit kita, yang ini kita tunjukkan kat mana kita spend the cash, and kat sini kita tunjuk cash kita receive daripada bond atau stock. Okay, so that's why dia nama dia cash flow lah, dia lebih nak tunjukkan cash yang kita dapat, okay, daripada profit, daripada operation kita, business kita, okay, cash yang kita spend on property dan sebagainya, cash yang kita invest dalam stock ataupun saham sebelum ni. Okay, so that generally financial statement that you need to know lah, balance sheet, profit and loss account and also cash flow statement. So these three will help you to make a business decision. Will help the bank managers, will help the investors to make the decision. Okay, whether to invest in your business or not, or whether as a bank manager, whether they want to approve your loan or not. Okay. So, financial ratio is an important part of financial analysis, okay, whereby the calculation and interpretation of various financial ratio will provide insight into a firm's future status. Okay. So, bila kita produce balance sheet, bila kita produce profit and loss account, and bila kita produce cash flow statement tadi, it's only on the piece of paper. So secara nyata kita boleh tunjukkan kekuatan company kita. Kita boleh tunjuk company kita aset banyak, hutang pun tak adalah banyak sangat. Profit kita boleh tunjuk, kita untung berjuta-juta setahun. Okay, apa yang kita nak nampak on the financial statement tu, apa yang tersirat tu. Okay, itulah gunanya financial ratio. Kita nak investigate what cannot be checked on the piece of paper. Okay, we want to have a look inside it. Okay, yang tersirat. Okay, yang tersorok. Okay, so asset memang banyak tapi adakah mencukupi? Okay, kita nak tahu tu. Okay, hutang dia dia tunjuk on the piece maybe tak tinggi, tapi adakah hutang tu akan membebankan syarikat? Okay, so kita boleh investigate. Okay, kita boleh gunakan financial ratio. Okay, profit tu tadi, untung juta-juta dia tunjuk, tapi adakah untung tu mencukupi untuk bisnes yang dijalankan? Okay, kita boleh investigate secara yang tersirat untuk kita tengok apa yang tersirat by applying these four categories of financial ratio: liquidity, okay, asset management, debt management and also profitability. Okay, so first kita tengok liquidity. Okay, again, just now I mentioned liquidity level ni very important in business. Asset yang kita boleh cairkan dalam masa yang singkat. Okay, so kita kena perbanyakkan aset-aset tu. Okay, so in liquidity ratio kita nak tengok the relationship between the cash, firm cash and also other asset and its current liabilities. Okay, so kita nak tengok current liabilities dengan hubung kait dia dengan cash ataupun asset. Okay, relationship between asset dengan liabilities, current liabilities lah. Okay, so ada four calculation yang kita boleh apply in order to check the liquidity level in the company's financial strength or capabilities. Okay, which are net working capital, working capital turnover ratio, current ratio and also quick ratio. Okay, T ni times ni nanti saya akan explain. Okay, first kita tengok working capital turnover. Okay, this is the formula. Okay, sales divided by working capital. Okay, remember yesterday saya ada remind dalam group, so focus juga on the file Excel. Okay, so dalam nak apply formula ni saya akan gunakan financial statement of CKD Sdn Bhd yang dalam Excel punya format, file Excel tu. Okay, so saya refer to that as reference for application of this formula in the note. Okay. Okay, apa yang dimaksud dengan working capital turnover ratio ni? Okay, the higher the sales, the higher the working capital is needed by the company. Maksudnya makin banyak you generate sales, makin banyak modal pusingan yang you perlukan. Okay. So, dalam kes ni kita tengok contoh CKD Sdn Bhd. Okay, the working capital turnover ratio measure how well a company utilizing its working capital to support for a given volume of sales. Okay, as I mentioned earlier. Okay, berapa banyak sales dia dapat, so berapa kali dia kena pusing setahun. Okay, ataupun untuk generate sales. Okay, kita tengok contoh CKD Sdn Bhd. Okay, ini file CKD Sdn Bhd tu. Okay, table 1 ni dia punya balance sheet untuk 5 tahun 2000. X ni kita boleh letaklah 2021 ke 2011 ke. Kita letaklah 2011 sampai 2015. Okay, 2011 until 2015 punya financial statement of CKD Sdn Bhd. Okay. So sales tak ada dalam balance sheet. Okay, yang ada dalam balance sheet hanya asset, liabilities dengan shareholders. Sales ada dekat table 2 which is profit and loss account. Okay, so ini dia punya sales. Okay, sales revenue atau sales, ataupun kadang-kadang dia letak revenue sahaja. Okay, okay, So kita ambil sales value tadi, RM5,950,000 divide by apa formula dia tadi? Divide by working capital. Macam mana dapat working capital? Korang? Apa tolak apa tadi? Current asset tolak current liabilities. Okay, untuk dapat working capital. Okay, current asset. This is current asset. Tolak current liabilities. This one. Okay, you akan dapat 650 650 630. Okay, itu the way you calculate. So you akan dapat 9.14 times. Okay, T ni times. Apa maksud 9.14 times ni? Maksudnya dia nak tahun 2011 CKD Sdn Bhd generate sale RM5,950,000. Okay, so dengan modal pusingan RM650,000 ni, dia kena pusing sebanyak 9.14 kali maksudnya. Okay, rolling sebanyak 9 kali lebih kurang lah. Okay, tahun berikutnya dia rolling lebih kurang 8 kali, 5 kali, 4 kali, almost 5 times, and the last in 2015 dia rolling almost 4 times. Okay, 4 times. Okay, so kalau you tengok dia punya sales setiap tahun meningkat. So, setiap tahun meningkat maksudnya dia make sure, kena make sure juga working capital dia ada ada peningkatan supaya dia boleh rolling untuk generate sales. Okay. So kat sini dia ada capabilities lah. Okay, even though in 2015 dia allocating for working capital has increased almost 4 times. Okay, making the working capital lower than before. They show that CKD Sdn Bhd is able to sustain a good working capital for a given volume of sales. Okay, walaupun sales dia meningkat setiap tahun, tapi dia ada still ada capabilities untuk rolling. Okay, untuk rolling dia punya working capital. Okay, so ada still positive number lah dalam kata-kata lain kat sini. Okay, so kita tak nak walaupun apa ni, 4 times ni is considerably agak kendal juga lah sebenarnya, tapi still ada ada capabilities untuk dia orang rolling begitu. Okay, alright, the next liquidity ratio yang kita boleh apply is current ratio. Okay, current ratio ni kita nak tengok again, nak tengok the company's ability to convert the cash to convert the asset into cash within less than a year. Kurang dari setahun, banyak tak aset yang dia boleh jual and dapatkan cash? Okay, so banyak tak aset dia? Okay, so ini formula dia. Current asset divide by current asset divide by current liabilities, and dia punya jawapan kena lebih 2 sepatutnya. Okay. So kalau rendah maksudnya there is a problem in terms of current asset of the companies. Okay, so because if the current asset current ratio is too low, it can lead to financial difficulty. But if it's too high, the use of capital is inefficient. Okay, so dia tak boleh terlalu rendah and tak boleh terlalu tinggi. Okay, walaupun dia kena lebih daripada 2, tapi kalau possible mestilah kurang 3. Okay, dalam kata lain dia mesti more than 2 but less than 3. Within that lah, between 2 to 3. Okay, kalau below 2, too low, dia ada financial difficulties. Maksudnya aset dia kurang yang dia boleh convert into cash. Okay, tapi kalau terlalu tinggi, dia terlalu banyak simpan aset yang perhaps sebenarnya dia boleh convert into cash and gunakan untuk benda lain. Okay, itu idea of current ratio. Okay, example ni kita gunakan CKD Sdn Bhd punya financial statement tadi. Okay, current asset divide current liabilities. Okay, current asset 1904,160 divide by current liabilities ni tadi. 1253,530. Okay. So, you akan dapat 1.52 times. Maksudnya dia punya current Asset are 1.52 times the value of current liabilities. Okay, so kurang 2. So, maksudnya 2011 ni ada masalah sikit dari segi current asset. Perhaps masa ni diorang baru start business. Okay, current asset diorang tak banyak. But you tengok daripada year from 2011 sampai lah 2015, dia punya current ratios meningkat, which is good for the business lah. So maksudnya from time to time they increase dia punya current asset punya level. So akhirnya pada 2015 dia ada 2.27 times dia punya current asset compared to current liabilities. Okay, so dia ada banyak lah asset yang yang boleh diterima, okay, dalam business punya level. Okay, untuk if anything happen to their business, they have the asset, that the current asset that they can convert into cash untuk bayar hutang dan sebagainya. Okay, itu yang dimasukkan dengan current asset, current ratio. Okay, quick ratio ni ataupun dikenali juga sebagai acid test ratio. Okay, which is known as acid test ratio juga. Okay, acid test ratio. Yang ini kita nak tengok asset yang kita ada tapi yang kita boleh convert into cash dalam masa kurang daripada 90 hari. Lagi cepat. 90 days. Kalau tadi setahun, yang ini 90 days. Okay, so in this case, formula dia sama, tapi in this case, kita kena tolak inventories. Even though inventories is part of current asset, tapi inventory ni susah. Kita nak convert into cash dalam masa tak sampai 10 hari. Yang ni problematic sikit. So that's why kita kena minus inventories. Okay, so this is the formula, current asset minus inventory divided by current liabilities. And jawapan you kena not less than 1, maksudnya kena lebih 1. Okay, kalau less than 1, you kurang current asset dalam bentuk quick ratio. Okay, so ini formula dia, ini application dia. So you ambil daripada CKD yang berhad tu tadi. Okay, tolak current asset, tolak inventories. Ini nilai inventories. Inventories. Okay, ini nilai current liabilities. Okay, you dapat 0.65. Okay, so masih unacceptable, rendah, below 1. Sama juga dengan 2012, tapi 2013 sampai 14 barulah the starting to increase more than 1. Okay, maksudnya from time to time the business of Secondary Sam Berhad doing well. Okay, means that they have the company's liquidity has improved consistently. Okay, from time to time dia meningkat. Okay, so it's good for their business lah. Okay, so means that they have a sufficient asset that have a liquidity level for current and also quick punya ratio. Okay, so that's what we call it as a liquidity ratio yang kita kena tengok in terms of asset dalam bentuk liquid. Okay, next kita tengok debt management of the companies. Okay, cara dia orang punya the way they manage their debt. Okay, sama ada hutang tu membebankan ataupun okay dalam level yang acceptable. Alright, so first kita boleh apply what we call it as a debt ratio. Okay, debt ratio ni kita tengok relationship between total liabilities with the total asset. Total hutang kita dengan total asset dia. Okay, kali 100%. Okay, the higher the debt ratio, increasing the business risk. Okay, maksudnya makin tinggi percentage you dapat, makin tak bagus untuk business. Makin merisikokan business untuk bankrupt dan collapse. Okay, so apa you boleh buat kalau debt ratio you tinggi? Perhaps you need to consider to obtain additional financing from the equity sources. Okay, perhaps you kena tambah shareholders punya equity. Okay, maybe you boleh lengthening the maturity of the debt. Maybe boleh negotiate dengan bank. Okay, untuk prolong the loan tenor. Okay, tambah duration ke. Kalau tadi you pinjam 20 tahun, baru bayar 5 tahun. Tiba-tiba you ada financial difficulties. So maybe you boleh negotiate dengan bank untuk tambah tempoh pinjaman. Okay, that's why dalam factors now obtaining social finance tadi penting for you to look at the flexibility of the loan. Okay, you boleh negotiate dengan bank untuk panjangkan tempoh pinjaman ataupun you boleh adjust debt repayment dates. Okay, lewatkan tempoh bayaran dan sebagainya. They can nanti. Okay, so you kena consider this kalau you punya debt ratio terlalu tinggi. Okay, example ya. Okay, so refer to Excel tadi. Okay, total liabilities, okay, current liabilities dicampurkan dengan long term punya liabilities, atau dalam kes ni adalah long term loan. The current asset yang ni campurkan dengan fixed current asset, oh, fixed asset ataupun non current asset, asset yang termasuk banyak, campurkan untuk dapat total. Okay, so you akan dapat 55.51%. Okay, so quite high juga lah. Alright, but as you can see, from time to time, the debt ratio of CKD Sam Berhad is decreasing, which is good. Okay, yang ni menurun, maksudnya bagus lah. They manage their debt efficiently. Okay, so kat sini kita boleh tengok, they can regain the confidence of the investors, but they shown that they manage their debt efficiently. Okay, so from year to year, dia menurun, dia punya debt ratio. Okay, sampailah pada 2015, which is only 43%. Okay, next is debt to equity ratio. Yang ini kita nak tengok relationship between total liabilities dengan shareholders equity. Okay, kalau tadi liabilities dengan asset, yang sekarang liabilities dengan shareholders equity. Ini pun sama, makin tinggi makin tak bagus untuk business. Okay, so the greater the debt to equity ratio, the greater the chance that company encounters financial difficulty. So maksudnya kat sini perhaps kalau terlalu tinggi, maybe dia boleh ask the investors to put more money, to invest more, to increase their investment and so on. Okay, so kita apply dekat formula dekat CKD Sdn Bhd punya financial statement. Okay, so you boleh nampak kat sini 100, almost 125%. Okay, tapi kat sini dia menurun. Okay, walaupun ada fluctuate little bit, menurun pada 2012, tapi pada 2014 dia naik balik. 2015 pun dia naik balik. Okay, ini menurun, naik balik. So kat sini I think even though ada color peningkat dan menurun, still it can show that the CKD Sdn Bhd can manage their debt efficiently lah. So kalau tak ada improvement, perhaps every year increase saja. So in that case, perhaps you need to revisit the investment made by the shareholders. Perhaps you need to invest more, ask them to invest more so that you can reduce your debt to equity ratio. Alright, next, asset management ratio. Okay, pengurusan aset. Macam ni kita manage aset kita. Adakah apa yang kita tunjukkan on the piece of paper tu, adakah memadai, mencukupi atau tak? Okay, so kat sini ada tiga ratio. Inventory, debt to sales ratio, ataupun dikenali sebagai account receivable ratio, and also creditors turnover ratio. Okay, kita tengok inventory turnover ratio. Yang ni kita tengok pengurusan inventory. Okay, macam ni kita manage inventory. Okay, ada dua, ada calculation dia ada little bit longer sikit. Okay, ada dua. Untuk calculate, first you kena calculate inventory turnover ratio. Ada dua formula you boleh pakai. Yang pertama yang ni, ataupun yang kedua yang ni. Okay, either one. Alright, so first, stock cost of goods sold divide by average inventory. And yang kedua, stock divide by cost of sales time 365. After you get the value kat sini, you kena masukkan kat sini, apply dekat second formula ni, average age of turnover. Okay, masukkan yang value kat sini, 365 divide by inventory turnover ratio. Okay, so ini makin tinggi dia dalam bentuk, jawapan dia dalam bentuk hari, days. Okay, so makin lama you simpan inventory, makin tak bagus untuk business. Maksudnya business you slow lah. Contoh macam you jaga barang runcit. Okay, barang kat store tersimpan dekat 3 bulan. Okay, which is not good for your business. Okay, sepatutnya the shorter the better. Okay, itu dalam konteks retailing punya business. Okay, kita apply dekat formula ni. Yang ni saya gunakan formula yang pertama. Okay, formula dia apa tadi? Cost of goods sold divide by average inventory. Okay, so yang ni you boleh dapat juga daripada table Okay. So average inventory tu, yang ni kadang-kadang disediakan lah, okay, dalam companies, dalam company financial statement kadang-kadang tak ada. Okay, that's why kalau tak ada, you kena gunakan formula yang kedua tadi. Okay, that's why saya cakap guna yang formula kedua, depends lah. Okay, tapi bila biasanya dalam exam, you kena pakai yang kedua lah. So, sebab dalam exam, dia tak adalah bagi sampai table 4 ni banyak sangat. Okay, kat sini kita tengok opening dengan closing inventory ni. You campur dua ni, divide by 2, you akan dapat average inventory. Okay, yang kat sini pun dia masukkan cost of goods sold, COGS ni tadi, 34879. Okay. So, untuk maybe dalam exam, you perlu focus on the second formula ni tadi. Okay, sorry. Divide by cost of sale. Okay. So you akan dapat 3.47 times. So dapat ni masukkan kat formula kedua tadi, 365 divide by 3.47, you akan dapat 105 days. So dia ambil masa 105 hari untuk clearkan dia punya inventory. Okay. 2012 menurun, 2013 menurun, 2014 dan ke-15, 2015 naik balik. Okay, maksudnya something wrong dengan dia punya business. Maybe quite slow. So that maybe they need to investigate lah. The manager should investigate, enhance dia punya marketing strategies so that they can clear up their inventories as quickly as possible. Okay, sebab inventories ni kalau you hold terlalu lama, it's not good for business. Okay, sebab bila inventory tu tak clear, you tak ada duit modal untuk you pusing, you tak boleh gunakan duit tu untuk benda lain. Okay, so that's why we call it as inventory turnover ratio. Debtors to sales ataupun account receivable ratio. Receivable. Okay, yang ini kita nak tengok keupayaan companies untuk mengutip hutang. Okay, so of course dalam business orang ada berhutang dengan kita. Okay, so makin lambat kita collect hutang, makin tak bagus untuk business kita. Okay, so itu dimaksud debtors to sales ratio. Okay, so ini formula dia, debtors divide by sales times 365 days. So usually you kena ambil masa kurang daripada 42 hari. Barulah kita boleh consider business you bagus. Okay, tapi kalau more than 42 days, okay, so it's not good for your business. Okay, again as I mentioned earlier. Alright, so ini kalau if the companies find it difficult to collect their debt, okay, to collect their debt, perhaps kita kena consider using debt factoring. Okay, macam saya explain dalam video last week. Okay, kita kena lantik agent untuk collect hutang untuk kita supaya kita dapat duit dalam masa yang cepat, supaya kita boleh rolling duit tu dan sebagainya. Okay, so kita tengok performance of SKDs yang berhad. Okay, dia punya formula adalah debtors divide by sales. Okay, debtors ada tulis kat situ. Alright, kadang-kadang dia tak guna terms debtors, dia guna terms account receivable. Okay, dalam balance sheet. So you kena aware lah benda ni benda yang sama. Okay, divide by sales. Okay. Okay, 73,560 divide by 5,950,000 kali 365. So dia ambil 45 hari untuk ambil collect dia punya debt. Okay, which is more than 42 days, which is not good. Okay, then 2012 turun sehari, 2013 sampai 14 makin lama makin lambat. Okay, should the management should investigate what's wrong with their management. Okay, why they taking longer time to collect their debt. Okay, so they can enhance dia punya follow up procedures. Okay, maybe dia kena kejar yang siapa yang berhutang dengan dia lah. Okay, so we show based on this result, it show that the companies or the management should do something in enhancing their follow up procedures so that they can collect their debt more faster. Okay. Alright, next is creditors turnover ratio. Yang ini kita nak tengok pula kekuatan company untuk membayar hutang. Okay, yang tadi untuk mengutip hutang, debtors. Yang ini untuk membayar hutang. Okay, beza kan? Alright, dia ada dua formula, creditors divide by purchases ataupun creditors divide by cost of sales. Okay, normally untuk exam, you gunakan yang kedua ni. Okay, times 365. Okay, yang ini normally company will generally prefer more days. Okay, Okay, untuk company kita baguslah. Okay, kalau kita ambil masa yang lama untuk bayar hutang. Okay, tapi untuk company yang kita berhutang tu yang tak bagus. Okay, diorang pula yang bermasalah. Okay, untuk kita bagus sebab makin lambat kita bayar hutang, makin bagus, makin banyak benda yang kita boleh gunakan duit tu. Okay, that's dia punya itulah. Tapi again, it's not good for from the point of view from the managers and also investors lah. Okay, so dia punya formula tadi, creditors. Okay, so ini pun ada dalam table. Ada lagi. Okay, creditors ni. Okay? Alright. So ini you kena total up.
Ayah.
Yes.
Cepat sikit
tau, ada komputer. Okay, okay. Okay, ini dia punya creditors 332. 030 and then purchases ni ada dekat online purchases. Purchases tu yang that's why saya cakap tak possible untuk guna first formula tu sebab dalam exam saya tak boleh bagi banyak-banyak table sangat. Nanti panjang pula you punya soalan. Ada kat sini cases bila option ini per cases 2383. Okay, bought in material ataupun purchases dia panggil. Okay, so kita gunakan tu ataupun kita boleh gunakan formula yang kedua. Creditors divide by cost of sale. Ini pun ada dalam table. So, cost of sale ni normally adalah dekat profit and loss ni, cost of sale. Okay, 424,500. Okay, masukkan. Walaupun jawapan dia berbeza kalau you tengok yang ni 21 hari, 29 hari. Tapi trend dia sama. Okay, ini naik. Yang ni pun naik. Okay, yang ni turun. Yang ni pun turun. Yang ni naik balik. Yang ni pun naik balik. Yang ni turun. Yang ni pun turun. Okay. Walaupun jawapan dia berbeza tapi trend dia sama. Turun naik. Okay. So, show that ada masa yang dia bayar, boleh bayar cepat. Ada masa yang dia boleh ambil masa little bit longer lah to pay their debts. Perhaps kalau you tengok pada 2012, dia lambat sikit. Maybe sebab tu dia ada bayar guna duit untuk bayar overdraft. And 2014, dia guna duit untuk beli plants and machinery. Okay, features and motor vehicles pada 2014. Okay, that's why dia takes a little bit longer to pay their debts. Okay, the last one is profitability ratio. Okay, profitability ratio show the combined effect of liquidity, asset management and debt on operating results. Okay, it's a combination of both of all the components yang kita tengok tadi lah. Okay, nak tengok profit level kita, berapa banyak kita boleh generate profit. Okay, antara ratio yang kita boleh calculate sama ada profit level of the business is acceptable or not. Gross profit, untung kasar. Net profit, untung bersih. Return on investment, return on capital employed, ROCE. Okay, kita tengok. First, gross profit, untung kasar. This is the formula, gross profit divided by sales time 100. So value ni you boleh dapat dalam table profit and loss account, financial statement profit and loss account. Dia ada gross profit, dia ada sales, dia tunjuk dalam tu. Okay. So gross profit of CKD Siam Berhad daripada 2011 sampai 2015 ada increment, ada peningkatan. Okay, ada peningkatan. From 2011 sampai kalau you tengok 29, 31, 34, 37, 40. Okay, untuk profitability ratio, the higher the better. Maksudnya makin tinggi percentage, makin bagus. Tak macam debt management. Debt management tu makin tinggi, makin tak bagus business. Sebab ini berkait dengan profit. Sebab tu makin kena makin tinggi. Alright? So, 40% pada 2015 dia punya gross profit. While net profit dia, ini kita tengok net income after tax. Divide by sales, ini pun yang boleh dapat daripada table profit and loss account. dia masukkan dalam formula, dia boleh nampak dia meningkat juga 4.2 ke 7.7. setiap tahun meningkat increment. So these two, okay, gross profit dengan net profit are interrelated, berkait. Okay, kalau gross profit you rendah, rendahlah net profit. Okay, kalau gross profit you tinggi, tinggilah net profit. Okay, so dia ada berkait dengan ini. Alright, so in order to get more, generate more net profit, you need to generate more gross profit. Okay, that's why tadi pun saya dah mention. Okay, nak dapat untung bersih yang tinggi, you kena generate ataupun nak, you kena dapat banyak gross profit. Kena tinggikan you punya gross profit. Okay, next is return on investment. Yang ini kita nak tengok kita punya return sama ada berbaloi ke tak dari segi investment yang kita buat. Okay, so basically ROI is one of the most important measures of the company's performance. Okay, antara yang penting lah. Later bila you belajar PED nanti masa part 7 pun you kena generate you punya ROI dan you punya project. Okay, so kat sini kita nak tengok daripada singgit yang apa ni, the ratio shows that the performance can be improved by generating more sales per RM RM1 of investment. Okay, berapa banyak sales dia boleh invest ataupun generate daripada RM1 of investment. Okay, so ini formula dia tadi. So ini you boleh refer to table apa ni, table 3 as well. Eh sorry, table 2 just now. Okay, combination yang ini daripada table 2 profit and loss account, ni table 1 balance sheet. Okay, masukkan dalam formula tiga yang dapat daripada CKD Sdn Bhd tu tadi. So yang boleh nampak kat sini 7.9% pada 2011. Again meningkat, walaupun 2013 dia ada menurun sikit, tapi sebab tu dia naik dan naik balik pada 2015 pada 11.82%. Okay, so kat sini dia investment dia adalah bernilai 11.82% lah return on investment dia. Dia quite reasonable and acceptable. Okay, the last one is ROCE in return on capital employed. So yang ini kita nak tengok setiap ringgit yang kita invest berapa banyak pulangan yang kita dapat. Okay, so ada dua formula. Okay, tapi untuk exam, kalau ada exam keluar pasal ni, you focus on this one sajalah, this formula sini. Yang ini kadang-kadang employed capital ni tak diberi dalam financial statement. Okay, so yang ini net operating profit ni you boleh tengok on table 3. Okay, cash flow statement. Yang ini of course dalam table 1 lah. Okay, so again as I mentioned earlier, kita nak tengok setiap ringgit yang kita invest berapa banyak profit yang kita dapat. Okay, so kita tengok ini dia boleh baca pulangan dia. Okay, untuk CKD Sdn Bhd pada 2011, setiap ringgit yang diinvest dia dapat pulangan 12 sen. Lepas tu meningkat 18 sen, 19 sen, and 2014, 2015, 21 sen. Okay, so setiap ringgit dia dapat pulangan 21 sen. Okay, quite worth it lah. Okay, so it's worth it lah. As a summary, ini dia punya summary. Cara ratio dia kita ambil latest 2015. Okay, industry no, industry ni, ini ataupun kita panggil dia industry norm. Industry norm ataupun standard business. Sebab dalam setiap business yang kita buat, jalankan, dia ada standard punya level. Okay, contoh macam CKD punya, Sdn Bhd punya business, dia punya standard dia current ratio sepatutnya dia kena dapat 2.05 minimum. Okay, tapi dia dapat 2.28. okay, which is good lah. Okay, lebih daripada minimum requirement. Okay, acid test ratio minimum requirement dia adalah 1.1. alright, and dia dapat 1.33. maksudnya bagus, good liquidity for both current and also acid test ratio. Okay, debt ratio minimum, debt ratio yang dia boleh ada dalam bisnes dia adalah 56% saja. Okay, so dia pada 2015 lebih kurang 43%. Okay, which is good lah, means that they manage their debt efficiently. Okay, so untuk debt to equity ratio sepatutnya minimum 130. So dia below that minimum, which is good. Okay, so sebab ni hutang. Okay, hutang kalau makin tinggi makin tak bagus. Okay, so untuk inventory turnover, ini untuk yang kita tengok berapa lama dia perlukan untuk clear dia punya inventory. So sepatutnya dalam bisnes yang CKD Sdn Bhd buat ni, dia perlu ambil masa minimum maksimum 122 hari. Sorry, 120 hari untuk dia orang clearkan dia punya inventory. Tapi dia terlebih selama seminggu. Okey, terlebih 127, maksudnya slightly poor. Okey, ada macam ni dia kena increase dia punya marketing strategi dan sebagainya supaya dia boleh clear dia inventory as quickly as possible. Okay, debtors to sales ratio. Ini untuk membayar hutang. Okay, sorry, untuk mengutip hutang. Okay, so sepatutnya dalam masa 60 hari dia orang dah dapat balik hutang dia. Okay, tapi terlebih 4 hari. Okay, still acceptable. Okay, tak adalah terlalu lama. Okay, creditors to turnover ratio. Ini kebolehan untuk membayar hutang. Okay, sepatutnya dalam masa 60 ke 90 hari dia kena bayar hutang dia. So, dia ambil masa 82 hari. Which is acceptable. Masih dalam within the range. Okay, gross profit. Patutnya dalam bisnes yang diorang jalankan ni, gross profit yang diorang kena dapat at least minimum 48%. Okay, so tapi dia cuma capai 40% sahaja. Okay, below the minimum requirement. Maksudnya tak bagus. Sebab dia melibatkan profit. Okay, slightly poor, dia maksudnya maybe you kena suggest some solution. Maybe kena reduce borrowing, kena reduce high interest rate punya borrowing. Kena reduce dia punya expenditure pembelanjaan. Maybe dia kena generate more sales dalam bisnes dia. Supaya dia dapat generate more gross profit. Okay, net profit minimum dia kena 15% tapi dia cuma capai 7.7% saja. So ini memang poor. Okay, again, as I mentioned, gross dengan net profit ni berkait. Kalau you improve you punya gross profit, net profit pun akan improve. So you kena suggest the same thing lah. Okay, ROI dia minimum dia 10%, you dapat 11.82% which is good. Maybe sebab dia punya asset quite good. Okay, ROCE dia dalam bisnes dia, dia kena setiap ringgit yang diinvest kena dapat pulangan at least minimum 22 sen. Tapi dia cuma dapat 21 sen, still acceptable. Okay, so this is also one of the things that you boleh jumpa dalam exam. Okay, this will you compare between industry norm ataupun industry standard. Okay, so ini you boleh baca, that's all. Soalan. Okay, of course it's a calculation. Kalau kita tak buat exercise, memang you tak boleh, susah you untuk you faham. Okay, I prepare exercise for you, exercise number 3 for this topic, financial statement. Okay, financial analysis, sorry. Okay, so this is the actual financial statement of SZRB ya. Ini bukan saya create, ini memang betul-betul saya ambil daripada website SZRB untuk tahun 2016. Okay, dia punya financial statement, ini dia punya balance sheet, table 1, table 2 dia punya profit and loss account, and table 3 dia punya statement of cash flow ataupun dia punya cash flow statement. Okay, so what you need to do is that you need to calculate the financial ratio for ISRB Sdn Bhd. Okay, this is the financial ratio you kena calculate. Semua yang kita belajar tadi ada 12 semuanya. Okay, and then you kena give your justification or answer on the SZRB's punya financial strength and also weaknesses. Okay, so try buat dulu lepas ni. Okay, tomorrow we are going to discuss the answer. Okay, so hopefully you try dululah. Okay, sebab kalau you tak try maybe little bit difficult for you to understand lah sebab ada calculation kan. Kalau you tak try dulu susah. Okay, but never mind, tomorrow kita akan discuss the answer lah. Okay, ada soalan? Apa yang Fu? Amy. Amy Islan, apa yang Fu ya? Ada soalan tak? Okey tak?
Perlu cuba try dulu doktor.
Yes, kena cuba dulu. Kalau tak, memang kita tak boleh nampak lah mana nak ambil apa. Okay, so you try dulu, tomorrow kita akan discuss and answer lah. Alright, and before I end up the session, just a remind, tomorrow kita akan ada one last session for this subject, BCM 523 virtual session lah. Okay, tomorrow last kita akan discuss the answer for the exercise. And next week we are going to have test number 2, okay, last assessment for you before you face a final exam for your paper 2. Okay, So test 2 will be based on this topic, okay, which is the financial ratio. Okay, test number 2. Okay, sama juga hari Rabu 4 to 6 lah, lebih kurang sama macam test 1 dulu lah. Okay, timing yang sama. Okay, so tomorrow saya akan brief more lah. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you for your time and commitment. Take care and stay safe. Okay, so that's all. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.